Good evening and welcome to the 8th grade class graduation of 2020. Class of 2020, I want to hear you! Awesome! You guys came out in full force. And class, when you were 7th graders last year, watching the 8th graders graduate, did you ever in your wildest dreams imagine that your graduation would be like this? No, you didn't. And your parents didn't imagine that. And I didn't imagine that. But you guys have rocked it. You have really persevered and prevailed. And we're just so very proud of you. I don't think it's an overstatement to say that we have all been collectively through a lot of weeks and months of trauma. And even in the last few days and weeks, we're watching in sadness all the racism and violence that has erupted across our nation. And as a Christian school, we have a duty to speak out against injustice and to equip our students with empathy and integrity and, yes, kindness. So tonight, before we pray, please join me in a moment of silence to honor those that we've lost. Please bow your heads. Father in heaven, we come to you tonight to honor an amazingly smart, talented, creative, compassionate class of 2020 grads. We thank you for them. We are blessed to know them. We ask, Jesus, that you direct their paths, direct their lives, help them to make a difference in this world, to be the change that we adults have not yet been able to achieve. Lord, we thank you for these students, their parents, their teachers, and this community that supports them. Bless us tonight in your precious name. Amen. Resilience is toughness. Resilience is the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. Resilience is elasticity. Resilience is the ability of a substance or an object to spring back into shape after it's been stretched. Resilience is the ability to be happy and successful again after something difficult or bad has happened. The word that I like to use is grit. And class of 2020, you guys have grit. And I want you to see this experience that you've gone through, that you're going through currently, as a blessing. Because can I tell you something about resilience and about grit? It is a gift. I hate to break it to you, friends. This is not the first time in your life you're going to be frustrated about something. It's not the first time in your life you're going to be disappointed about something. But do you know what we know about successful people? They have grit. And here's how you get grit, just like any skill, you practice it. And you go through junky stuff. It's hard, and there's blood and sweat and tears and maybe even some laughter, we hope. And when you make it through and you've survived, you realize, hey, I'm okay. I didn't love that, but I made it through. And that's grit. When you realize that you made it through, you're less fearful. And when you're less fearful, you're willing to take risks and try new things and shoot for the moon and all those cliches. But without grit, you can't make it happen. Without being forced to practice getting through that tough stuff, you won't have the confidence to keep going. But you, class of 2020, have proven yourselves gritty. You are gritty, and I want you to wear that as a badge of honor, as something to be proud of, because it will take you far in life, my friends. I love you. I'm proud of you. So blessed to be here with you tonight and celebrate this awesome occasion. And on that note, I'm thrilled to introduce to you your 2020 eighth grade class president, Mr. Tanner Duffy. Let's give him a huge round of applause.
Good evening, and welcome to the first ever Rogers Avenue School parking lot graduation. Welcome parents, friends, and those who are connecting with us through the virtual world. I would like to thank you for being there for us when we needed it the most. I would also like to thank all the teachers, because without them, we wouldn't be sitting in our cars today. Lastly, I would like to thank Google, Wikipedia, Zoom, and the inventor of copy and paste. May he rest in peace. Parents and students, these past 9 years may have felt like an eternity, but you've reached the end. We are the class of 2020, a year filled with unexpected changes. This year has been a real roller coaster and seems to have passed by in a blur. Days spilled into weeks and melted into months. Things might look a little different, and the year seems to have compacted in the past 3 months. Change might seem difficult at first, but you can always trust that God's got your back and that the sun will rise again tomorrow. Now, as you get out of your car and cross the stage, remember this. The future might seem uncertain, but embrace all the possibilities that the future has in store. A few things I've learned through my 8 years at Rogers, I pass along to you as you head to high school. In the words of Mr. Lang, it's okay to color outside the lines. Art has rules, so you can break them. Be true to yourself. You're the only you. Be confident in who you are. Stand up for those who are unable to stand up for themselves, and they will stand up for you. Never let others' opinions get you down. God's opinion is the only one that matters. Don't procrastinate. It won't always end well. I ask you to take with you all the good times we shared at Rogers. Family groups, Red Ribbon Weeks, Spirit Days, Weeks of Prayers, and especially our eighth grade raft trip. I know all of my classmates have their own memories of Rogers. This is an amazing place, and we will remember it always. And I can't end my talk without bringing up our last few months of school. At the moment, it feels like the only thing I can remember is quarantine and Zoom meetings. Was it hard? Sure. Was it easy to procrastinate and not do my work? Totally. But look, we made it, and we can make it through anything because we are the champions. Boris Becker once said, I can't change history. I don't want to change history. I can only change the future. I'm working on that. The future always has unexpected changes. We didn't know six months ago that we'd be sitting here stuck in cars in every other space waiting for the next pandemic update. But it's your choice to complain about your circumstances or to embrace the change and make the future something worth looking forward to. For the love of everything good, holy, and true, put your name on your paper. Wise words from Mrs. Crawford, who I wish was here. We love you, Crawford, and thank you for being here for us. Mrs. Gish, Mrs. Busby, Mr. Hogate, and especially Mrs. Bryant, thank you for putting up with us for these past few years and for being there no matter what. Without you, this graduation would not have been possible, and I thank you for working tirelessly to make this a reality. And Mr. Hogate, we are sad to see you go, but we are excited for you and wish you the best. And if you get bored, you know where to find us. These past few months, you have stretched the limits of yours and our technology skills. I thank you for never giving up and always being there when we needed help. Class, you're the most amazing group of people I've ever met. We are all so different, yet those differences are what bring us together. Don't let anyone deny that we are extraordinary. Well, you may have forgotten everything I said, but I want you to remember this. Class of 2020, embrace change, live life to the fullest, and strive to be the best you can be. We got this. Remember Rogers, remember this community, remember these people. Remember this place, home.
Parents are a vital, integral part of our program here at Rogers, and never so much this year than any other year, because you all are also teachers along with us, and we thank you for that, and we honor you for that. Tonight is actually a perfect example of this. The decorations that you see set up, all done by eighth grade parents. Big thanks to Robert, Karina, Richard, Sarah, John, Lori, Troy, Stacy, Nicole, Hillary, Heidi, Jenny, and Jennifer. Does the stage look amazing? Can we give them a huge thank you? At each Rogers graduation, we like to take a moment to honor the parents who are graduating their last Rogers student and who have really gone above and beyond the call of duty for help in the classroom. The Simpson, Trees, Harris, and Ellis families have all helped with parties and field trips. They were always up for whatever a teacher needed. Brent and Heather Scully worked hard helping with field trips, parties, reading groups, playing with kids at recess, doing bake sales, and helping with worships. That was super integral to our kids' lives. Stacy Schwartz helped with everything and anything she was asked to do. Helped in classroom math with both of her girls, could always be counted on to help with parties and trips. The Dodds family was all in. Amy taught Spanish before the Spanish program became a thing here at Rogers. She played piano for the kids' Brookdale visits, taught Carnegie Art Labs. On Monday morning, she regularly came and helped students with their journal writing. And Greg was a member of the school board and was the school board chair for years. Both helped with trips, parties, and vespers. The Larson family has also been an integral member of the Rogers family, graduating their last Rogers student after too many years to count. Lori helped teaching important health classes, and Barbara is the creator of this beautiful eighth grade banner that you see over here to my left with the 2020 logo for our kids. Finally, Tanner touched on this for a second, but we have to give a big, huge thanks to Mr. Ralph Hogate, who after 41 years is retiring. And what a way to end your 41st year of teaching, right? Without kids in your classroom. Some of you came by and appreciated him at our drive-through parade, and we really appreciated that. But for all of these parents and for Mr. Hogate, let's give them a big round of applause and honks and whatever y'all are going to do. All right, so the moment you've been waiting for, the part that your kids are really here for, and that is the opportunity for them to walk across our stage. And let me explain to you how this is going to go. You're going to follow the car in front of you in that order. So for instance, the Boos family, thank you, John, is pulling out right now, and they're gonna pull up to the start sign, and at that point, their student may get out and sign the banner. The Marson family then would also pull out and go to the wait sign. So they're on deck waiting to pull up. Everybody else stays in their spot until each car has gone through. And so once the Marsons have gone through, then the Duffys will come up and go to the wait sign and we'll go all the way through. Your child will exit the car, sign the banner, and you're welcome to follow in your car along, videoing them if you want, watching them as they go. They're going to come up here to me. Their diplomas are in their gift bags, but I'm going to hold a diploma next to me, and they're going to stand next to me for a picture. We're not going to do any exchange of items, but once we've taken that photo, then they'll go down and come around here where they'll deposit their robe and their and they'll get their gift bag, and you can pick them up there and either head back to your spot, and we hope you do, or if you need to head home, that would be fine too. So that's how that process is going to go. At this point, I want to welcome Lori Duffy up, our school board chair, who is going to be reading the names for our graduates.
Timothy Boos.
Thank you.
Kailani Marson. Tanner Duffy. Haley Tucker. Thank you. Eric Lopez. Ethan Varnell. Clayton Knowles. Tommy Anderson. Dawson Catlett. Lexington Knopft. Gonzalo Schimpf. Abby Avendano. Denise Garcia. Sarah Palmer. Olive Delph.
Thank you.
Kylie Castleman. Danica Larson. Kiara Diaz. Chloe Carambeau. Clara Scully. Lillian Schwartz. Noah Perez. Thank you. Ashton Ellis. Lauren Ellis. Serena Rao. Jackson Guerra. Thank you. Nell Dodds. Katie McCoon. Jason Roberts. Megan Larson. Audrey Bryan. Madison Irving. Mateo Carr. Noah Simpson. Mia Ramos Herrera. Samantha Beard. Spencer Rich. Thank you. Amelie Potzer. Eliel Rivero. Andrew Thomas. Samantha Trees. Ellie Harris. Lily Borges. In absentia, Ravimbo Tarawingo.
All right, let's hear it one more time for the class of 2020. I know it wasn't what you were expecting, but this was a really fun grad, and we just thank you so much for your patience with us, for your flexibility. You guys, Rogers families, there is no other. There is no other. You guys are amazing, and we just are so thank you. And I'm telling you, class of 2020, there is no other. You will never, ever be forgotten. You guys are amazing. Please bow your heads with me for a word of prayer. Father in heaven, you have blessed us tonight with the personality of these kids, and we just, our hearts are full and overflowing with joy and pride and love. And we thank you, Jesus, for giving us such awesome kids, such awesome families. And I pray a blessing on these students as they go into their future. In your name, amen. All right, so now here's the plan. We are going to parade, but on your way out, you're going to want to pick up your yard sign. So we're going to start just how we went through with the Boost car. They're going to pull out, and Mrs. Busby and Mrs. Gish and maybe Mr. Hoagie will run down here, and they're going to pull that sign out for you wherever you are. So you might kind of point it out to us. So pull along the curb, and they'll grab that sign for you, and then we're going to come out through the pull-through lane. We're going to turn right on Academy Way. We're going to go left on 4th, left on College Ave, and left on Whitman, making that full circle. I know that there are people out there who want to love on you and cheer for you and just be supportive of you. So we'd love for you to participate in our parade. And after that, you're free to head on home. So thank you. We'll just follow in order here, starting with Boost, going Boost, Marson, Duffy. You know the drill. You did it once already. Thanks so much, guys. Good night.
Thank you.
Thank you.